how much time do you currently spend on managing your Google Shopping product feed? Now, what if I were to tell you that you could create that feed in just a few minutes, have it automatically update if any changes are made to your product, and use it to resize and rename all of your images automatically to fit Google Shopping best practices? Well, you're in luck, because that is exactly what I'm going to show you in this video. Because most businesses spend hours taking their data from their main online shop, tweaking that data in spreadsheets in order to fit Google Shopping's requirements, and then importing that back into their Google Merchant Center, all while hoping that their products don't get rejected by Google. But you're not like most businesses, are you? I see you. You are here trying to improve your processes. So stick with me, because by the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to create a feed that's faster, more accurate, and that can save you hours of work every week. But first, if you're into e-commerce tips and tricks that actually work, hit that subscribe button, because we're all about helping you work smarter, not harder. All right, to create this feed, we are going to be using a pre-made template from Plytix. I'm leaving a link to where you can get it in the description. And for those of you who don't know, Plytix is a product information management tool where you have this one central place to store all of your data from all of your different channels. And there are additional features like digital asset management, so you can store things like images and videos together with your products, and channels, which simplify how you create feeds. In fact, with Plytix, you can create feeds for all kinds of platforms: Shopify, Amazon, Facebook ads, and of course, what we're focusing on today, which is Google Shopping. So to get started, we are going to click on Add Channel, select the Google Shopping option, fill in this information so we know what this feed contains, and then we'll be taken to this page where you'll see these tabs here. As you can see here, it's open to the instructions tab, but this tab actually disappears and turns into something else the first time you use this feed. But don't worry, because if you need any help, you can always come back to this video where I explain everything you need to know, starting with the products tab. This is where you choose which products you want in your feed. You can use a product list that you've created beforehand, or you can create a new one if you want to add a specific group of products. Honestly, there are so many things that you can do with product lists that there's a whole video about it. So if you want to learn all of the cool tricks that you can do with them to save time, make sure you check it out on our channel. Next, we have the mapping tab. Now, this is where the magic happens, because you don't have to memorize what fields Google needs for your feed, because when you click on the mapping tab, you'll see that Plytix already has a template with everything set up for you. It's actually one of my favorite things about this template, and I say one because my actual favorite thing is going to come a little later in this video, but this is one of my favorite things because right off the bat, it identifies the required fields and the optional fields. So the bare minimum to list your products for Google Shopping ads, and then the more detailed information that will help you meet the data requirements for free listings. I do want to take a second here to say that the fields under the required section are the most basic requirements for all products. But depending on the product that you're selling, you might also be required to include some of the fields in the optional section. Since it's not required for all products in all countries, the field is under the optional section, even if it is required for a specific product. Does that make sense? Now, the first step here is to map the Google Merchant Center fields in this column to the information or the attributes that you have for your products. So for this first field, you can match ID to SKU, for example. The next field we have here is title. For this one, we're gonna do something a little special, because if you haven't seen our last video, we spoke with a Google product manager who gave us some insider tips on how to optimize your Google Shopping listing. And I'll link that video in the description of this video. But one of the things that we learned from him is that you shouldn't just copy and paste your product title from your online store to Google Shopping. There's actually a recommended structure to create an optimized title, and it means combining different attributes. Now, rather than having to go to a spreadsheet, look for that information, and then put it together, you can do it directly in this feed. So for example, the most basic structure he mentioned for title is to have brand name, product type, and some kind of descriptive attribute. Now, I'm not gonna go and write that in for each single product. Instead, I'm going to click on match attribute here, then click on create computed. I'm going to give it a name so that I know what it is. And then I'm going to use one of Plytix's formulas to create the title based on the information I want. In this case, I'm going to use the formula concat, which concatenates or combines different values. Then I'm going to choose the attributes brand, product type, and let's say color, because that's what I want my title to include. I can test out what this would look like. So if I'm selling a white hoodie from Nike, Plytix will now pull from the attributes that I've chosen to create that title. And you can play around with this formula to include different things. But the cool part is that once you have your formula, Plytix will apply it to all of the products in this feed and only for this feed. So it's not gonna mess with your online store's title or anything. Now, moving on to what actually is, hands down, my favorite part about this feed, and that's how it deals with images. Now, in a normal spreadsheet or template, you'd have to add the image URL to the correct column, which is normal and standard, right? But a lot of times we don't realize that we actually have to adapt our images for Google Shopping first. I mean, you need to make sure that it meets the image size requirements and best practices, right? So most people will take the image, go to a different tool, resize their image, resave that image, and then add that new link in. But remember, you are not most people. You are ahead of the game, and you're about to learn how this feed is like none other you've ever seen. Because remember when I said that Plytix has digital asset management features? Well, you can store the highest resolution of your images directly in Plytix, and you can and should attach said images directly to its corresponding product so that you can include images in your feed. For example, in this Google Shopping feed, I'm gonna match the image link field to the attributes high res main image. Then I'm going to click on this settings button here. And as you can see, you have a few options, but the one that we're interested in right now is that resize option, because when you click it, you can choose what you want to resize your images to. And once we process this feed, meaning once you use this feed to add or update products on Google Shopping, it'll resize all of the images in this Google Shopping feed just for this feed. So again, it's not messing with your original images. It's like magic. You can also change image format from JPEG to PNG and vice versa, or rename your image files to include product attributes, for example, brand and product type. And there's one more piece of magic that I want to share with you, which is once you've set everything up, once you've chosen your products, mapped your fields, and optimized your images, Plytix keeps your feed updated automatically. Anytime that you change a product price or you add a new variant or update inventory, Plytix pushes those changes to Google Shopping without you lifting a finger. Imagine the hours that you're saving. Instead of manually updating 10 different feeds every time something changes, you just make the change once in Plytix and it updates across all of your channel feeds. And this not only saves you time, but it also drastically reduces human error, and it ensures that listings are always accurate and that you never miss a sale because of outdated data. Now to do this, just head to the settings tab here, scroll down to the scheduling section and toggle it on. You can even choose how often you want it to process or update. Then you can save your changes and process your channel. When you process it for the first time, you'll notice that a URL will appear here. And this is the URL that you'll use in your Google Merchant Center, which I'll show you how to do in just a second. But first, let's go to where our instructions tab used to be in the headers here. And you'll notice that it's now a process log so that you can keep track of when this feed was processed and if it was processed by the system based on the schedule that you set, or if it was processed manually by a user in your Plytix account. Now, to connect the feed that you created in Plytix to your Google Merchant Center account, just log into your account, go to products, add products, and add another product source. Select add products from a file, and then paste the URL from your Plytix feed and click continue. Once Google Merchant Center processes that URL, you'll see the number of products that were updated and the number of products that were added. And that's how you create an automated Google shopping feed in Plytix. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below. And if you want to give Plytix a try and start building your own product feeds, check out the link in the description. And of course, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to this channel and hit that notification button so that you never miss any tips or tricks on e-commerce and how to work smarter, not harder, when it comes to your product data. See you next time.